There are two gods. There's the god of the Bible and the god of the mind, the self-god. So, how did the god of the Bible originate? Well, first off, we have the farmers of old, of ancient years, dividing up their seasons. And most notably with the months, you had the moon. Some years were like divided up by all moons, so that's the moon year was different from the sun year, so that created some problems. But we get to 12, and the moon was divided up into fours, and that's how we get to the 7 days. Now, your tribe of Israel, they were ping-ponging between Egypt and Babylonia, and they picked up some of their stuff. And you've got these old deities of theirs, the Amen, Atum, Nat, etc. like that. And those stories were picked up. So then you get the 7 days creation. There's a lot of creation stories around, flood stories, and that's how they come about. 12 disciples, you've got the Theban creation, the Pothian creation. So if you want to say, no, that's just poetry, then you have to think, where then do you get your original sin from? You could say, I have to be forgiven for believing some poetry. That doesn't make some sense, does it? So then you get to Adam and Eve, and then you've got this, like, they're the first, but where did Cain's wife come from? So then you say, that's poetry again. So you say, well, what's original sin? What am I doing praying for, you know? What do I need to be praying for? Also, when you've got morals, these people say, like, our morals are in the religious texts. The religious texts are based on other people's writings from the ancients and their faith that there was a God. But God isn't proved, that's why it's called a faith. So then you have the morals based on a faith that something else exists, but it's not proven. So then the other version is the self-God, intelligent design. So it says, we're so finished, like with a finished clockwork piece. How could this be so? I mean, well, life looks too good. But it's a long process, it's called evolution, and it's in the books. You've got survival of the fittest. Man is not the end product, not finished, it's part of an evolutionary process. We are not like, oh, we are the finished object, or we are the centre of time. Mankind is at the centre of everything. The sun goes round us, we're at the centre of the universe. That is not the case. Time moves on, evolution moves on, we are not the finished product. We are not the finished clock. We are part of a process. In evolution, in time, in space. As you can see, we've got the little dinosaur here. Man is there, somewhere in the middle. The sun doesn't go around the earth. We're in time and space, a part of time and space, not dead centre. And creatures adapt. The universe is not man-centric. That is to say, man is not the be-all of the universe. I mean, we think like we're the only ones here on this planet, like we're the only intelligent creatures, we're the most, so therefore we are the main thing, we're the most dominant. But when it comes to the universe, we go, oh, there's something out there, but we don't know what. But there's billions of stars, there must be something out there.